Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about creating a smart deploy reference virtual machine within Server 2019. So let's get started. All right, so hopefully you guys have your smart deploy console up and running. We are going to click on re-image devices, click on build virtual machine. It's going to start loading up, and you're going to get the build wizard. Click on next. And within your virtualization software, if you click on that drop-down menu, this is all the software that smart deploy is compatible with. I'm going to pick Hyper-V, and for your guest operating system, you are able to click on the drop-down menu. And for Hyper-V, it has all supported operating systems, but when you pick it, the next button doesn't highlight, so I can't click on next, right? So I clicked on Support Center, took me to the website to look into how to create a virtual machine. And within their example, it looks like VMware Workstation works out with no problem. So I found myself a copy of VMware Workstation. I got a copy of Pro 12. Because that's what supported within Smart Deploy. I double clicked on the folder. I double clicked on the VMware Workstation EXE. It started loading up. I clicked on next. I accept the license and terms, clicked on next. From here, I clicked on next. I left everything as the default, clicked on next. I just installed it and it was installing and boom. And I licensed it, I finished it, and I was done. I double click on the VMware Workstation Pro to make sure it's up and running. Plus, I wanna show you guys that there's no virtual machines that are running on this console. I went back inside Smart Deploy, clicked on Build Virtual Machine, started loading up, got the Build Wizard, clicked on Next. And for the virtualization software, I hit that drop-down menu and I pick Workstation 12 Pro because that's what I have. The guest operating system, you're able to click on the drop-down menu and then pick your poison. I picked Windows 10 x64, and then that next button was highlighted, so I clicked on Next. From here, give your virtual machine a name. By default, it drops it inside the Smart Deploy folder, inside a folder called Reference Machine. So I left everything as the default and I clicked on Next. From here, I clicked on Browse and I picked my Windows 10 64-bit ISO file and I clicked on Next. Once you click Next, it gives you a nice little checklist of what you need to do. I kind of find it strange that Smart Deploy does not automatically start the virtual machine up for you, which is kind of weird. It wants you to start the virtual machine, run all the Windows updates manually, install all the applications that you want. It also advises you not to sit prep the machine. Once you have your Windows updates and all your applications installed within your reference virtual machine, just shut it down normally. Click Finish. Because I picked VMware Workstation, it's gonna prompt me, how do you want to open up the file? So I picked VMware Workstation, clicked OK, and it loads up the console. Again, with that checklist, it wants me to start it up, push out all the Windows updates, also push out all the applications, and once I'm done, just shut it down. Now, on the next video, I'm gonna show you guys how to capture it because I already did that within my Hyper-V. I created a Hyper-V virtual machine and it's my template. The only thing I didn't do within this virtual machine is I didn't sit prep it. I just shut it down normally. And that's it, guys. That is how we create a smart deploy reference virtual machine within Server 2019. We did it with VMware Workstation, but you are able to create with Hyper-V. The only difference is that the console or smart deploy console doesn't automatically open up Hyper-V. These are a couple of things that I do not like about smart deploy. It would have been cool if it opened up or located my Hyper-V server and then automatically create it for me, but it doesn't do that. I have to actually manually create a virtual machine within my Hyper-V. The next video that I'm going to show you guys dealing with smart deploy is all about capturing your reference image, and I'm actually going to use a Hyper-V machine, so stay tuned for that. Other than that, guys, hopefully you guys enjoy. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, punch, smash, and elbow that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out. Why, hello, welcome. So if you guys are tuning in to the Smart Deploy mini series that I have been creating for you guys, believe it or not, I could get you guys a awesome deal. On your desktop, we are going to open up our favorite browser. I'm gonna open up Google Chrome. We're going to type in smartdeploy.com/BTNHD, hit enter. It's going to take you here and you are able to get a free license to manage 15 machines for free forever. Just click on that button that says get free licenses. It's gonna take you here. You're gonna enter your business email address and hit that get subscription button. And once that's done, wait about 3 days. You will receive an email from Smart Deploy to continue your subscription. And that's it.